So I am going to discuss this scientific progress in Pakistan from 1947. Pakistan had very inadequate infrastructure for education and scientific research in 1947 when it came into existence. There was only Punjab University, and it had a very small size. 1959 to 1969, this was a period of stability, political stability. So government succeeded in making long-term policies for education, science, and technology. Dr. I.H. Usmani became chairman of Atomic Energy Commission, and Professor Abdul Salam was part-time member of the commission. So I.H. Usmani made the commission, revitalized the commission, and a massive training program was started. More than 500 scientists in the areas of natural sciences were sent abroad for training, and in many cases, leading to PhD degrees. In 1966, Qaid-e-Azam University was established, and this university played a very important role in the scientific development of Pakistan. An attempt to provide an industrial base to the country was also laid down during this period. Despite numerous political and economic problems, educational and scientific and industrial development continued, but at a slow pace compared to rapid population growth, which had increased the economic problems tremendously. The second best period for higher education in Pakistan was 2000 to 2008, when Professor Abdul Salam, a scientist, was made the Minister of Science and Technology in Pakistan. During this period, Higher Education Commission in Pakistan was established, headed by him, and more than 700 students were sent abroad for higher training. At present, I think there are more than 100 universities in Pakistan, 400,000 students there, but we need to raise the quality of our research work as well in our country. Though the results of HEC, Higher Education Commission programs, are not 100% according to expectations, yet its contributions to scientific development of the country are appreciable. Abdul Salam ICTP has played a vital role in the scientific development of Pakistan. Many scientists who were working in Pakistan, they had continuous link with NCP and they have with ICTP, and they succeeded in forming active research groups in Pakistan. So the following the same idea as ICTP, a center, National Center for Physics in Pakistan, has been established. The vision of the center is the center will evolve into a center of excellence in the area of physics and would establish itself on the pattern of Abdul Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics. Professor Riyazuddin, student of Professor Salam, and many other senior scientists, they struggled hard to establish this center, and Professor Riyazuddin was founding director general of this center. The center formally came into existence in 2004, and Dr. Ishfaq Ahmed played an important role in addition to getting required funds for the center. The center has excellent facilities for visiting scientists and holds several conferences, workshops, knowledge, and 50 research papers center has published in 2010. More than 20 scientific events have been held. So, and 40 foreign scientists have visited the center. Knowledge and art are above all prejudices like race, religion, and culture. The present threat to global security can be minimized by promoting education and research in the region and in the whole world. So I just point out a few problems which we are facing in Pakistan for the development of science. First is the lack of awareness of the importance of education and research in the public. Still small scientific base due to lack of human resource. Highly trained teaching staff in universities is not according to requirements. Commitment at the political level is minimal. Bureaucratic hurdles. We need to focus on quality, not only on quantity. Pakistan has an additional problem at present of its isolation from the developed world due to security situation. The visits of foreign scientists to Pakistani universities and institutes can be very useful in promoting the scientific thinking and scientific culture in the country. The security situation is improving, and I hope NCP will be able to play its role even better by facilitating foreign scientists to visit Pakistan in near future. I think to make this globe a very peaceful and homogeneous, we need to develop scientific interactions with first world, advanced countries, as well as within the developing countries. So that's it.
Thank you. Thank you.